LOHAS, elephantjournal.com, and it's my honor.
I'm very excited. I'm more excited to meet with Graham Hill than even eco model superstar Summer Rae Oaks. So Graham Hill is the founder of Treehugger. Most of us have heard of that, if we, especially in Boulder, where we've been tree hugging for decades. Mm-hmm. So tell me about Treehugger. How did you get involved? How did it go? I heard it did okay. And it's doing okay.
It went okay, and we're just getting warmed up, so it's going well.
That's right.
Started in 2004, and essentially I saw this little pieces of a very compelling modern green future out there, but there really wasn't a place on the web that had brought it all together.
Right.
And so I wanted to make green much more aspirational and much more convenient, because I thought that would really help mainstream it.
What does aspirational mean?
Just that you could step into it, be something you want to become part of.
It would make show it cool.
Make it cool.
Yeah.
You could get a sense of the movement.
I see.
And make it sort of something you would want to step into.
I see. Well, that's something that I think you probably get a lot of credit for, but we should note is that Treehugger really branded green. It was one of the first to brand green as something hip, modern. Dwell has done a great job of that.
Mm-hmm.
So I understand a year ago, or I don't know how long ago anymore, it seems like a year,
yep.
You sold to Discovery?
Yep, around nine months ago in August. Yep.
So when you were, I know 15 companies were looking at hoping to buy you, when you were looking to kind of take it to the next level in terms of getting the green word out,
mm-hmm.
why did you choose Discovery? What did you look for?
Well, it was a real no-brainer with Discovery. Uh-huh. I mean, we talked to a lot of different companies. To go mainstream, you want to hit the mainstream. Discovery hits the mainstream in a major way. So they have like 1.5 billion subscribers. They're in 100 countries. They're all over, and they're a very well known brand, which is really high quality, and really their logo is the globe. They've been associated with the earth and nature forever. So it just was very easy, and we got along well, and the people are great, and so it was an easy
decision.
So
you didn't think about selling to Disney, for example? Yeah.
We didn't talk to Disney.
Yeah, yeah. So a year later, how do you feel about the sale? Do you still feel in charge of your own life, in charge of what Treehugger is doing? I know your traffic continues to go through the roof. You're now in charge of Planet Green's website.
Yep.
What are you up to now?
Well, it's gone great. I mean, obviously, going from being a small business and entrepreneur to working for a big company, it's different. But they're actually a really great company to work with. They've been somewhat hands off, but also been very helpful. And so our traffic has grown, and being part of this channel is really amazing. So it's a real multi-platform thing, and overall, it's great. I've been having a good time, and we've lost very few people, and traffic's increased. So it's great.
So, you mentioned the channel. So Discovery for many years has been doing some green, eco, environmental stuff. Now they're doing a little bit more than just some stuff, right? Tell me about Planet Green.
It's really significant, and that's why I really liked it. It's really the biggest bet in green media. So they're
how big a bet is
they're
that?
Really pushing it. Well, I think the initially it was like $50 million just to do the channel, and but more just in what they're attempting to do. They put the first 24-hour eco lifestyle channel. It's hitting 50 million homes, so it's very, very significant. Yeah. 14 odd shows, and they've got some great personalities and some great experts, and it's almost entirely unique content, and so they've really gone where no one else has gone before. So it's a very big push. And then there's treehugger.com, which they're really supportive, and then planetgreen.com, which they've launched. And so it's a very big bet, and I'm really happy to be part of it.
So on a more fundamental or personal level, it seems like your passion, why do you care about green, and why is your passion through media getting it out to everybody?
Well, I think this is the issue of our times. This is whether we like it or not, and so I want to have as much influence as I can. Media is a great way to do that.
Uh-huh. Why is media the way to do that? I mean, there's a lot of ways to focus on green, obviously.
Yeah, there are many ways. Well, particularly the internet, it's a place people go to get information to figure out how to do things. Mm. It's becoming more and more mainstream, more of a place that you go to. So it's a great way to affect change. So I think it creates, it spreads information, it makes it aspirational, it allows people to communicate and connect. So there are many ways to do this, but I think media is a critical component of it.
So in your entrepreneurial career, I know you started off with the iconic paper cup in New York. What's that called?
It's the website's wereyourhappytoserveyou.com, and it's a it's a little
kind of Grecian or something.
It's a Greek design, and it's after a paper coffee cup that's been sold since the '60s, and they still sell a couple hundred million of them. So I developed a ceramic version as sort of a comment on on consumerism, and it's a nice little side business. Yep.
And then was Treehugger next, or was there another stop in between?
Those were around the same time. Prior to that, I got involved in the internet very early, so I started a web firm with my cousin in 95 out in Seattle that developed websites. And so I did that and sold it to a New York company. So I've been doing internet for quite a while.
And do you feel like Treehugger is what you want to focus on for the next little while with Planet Green?
Yeah, I really want to work with Discovery to build it up. And you know, the page views and all that stuff, it's I like those numbers. And it shows influence to me, and so I really want to build it and try to push it along for sure.
Well, fantastic. Thank you. It's great to meet you at
last. Great to meet you as well.
Graham Hill, Treehugger, Planet Green.